Hello everybody, my name is Good and welcome back for another video of Middle Ages 2. Choice of life, boys. Choice of life in Middle Ages 2. Let's do this. Let's look at that big fish though, holy. So yeah, we're basically in the middle of a war. Last video, if you missed it, go ahead and watch it. You missed a lot because it was a big war that got declared against the Southerners because they attempted to kill me. They attempted to assassinate me and it did not work. Now I'm into the battlefield. Actually won a major battle over here and we're moving on to the medical staff right here. It's medical chambers. We're gonna look at after our injured soldiers right here. I kind of did a big mistake though. My tactic was really great, but I made a mistake early on by charging right into the enemy. I thought that was gonna work, but I kind of fucked up my cavalry right there, so I gotta be more smart in the moment, I guess. Long term, I'm really smart, but in the moment, like short term, into the battle itself, I'm not really that smart. So you gotta think about that, boys. You sit in a large tent that you pitched near the battlefield and think about the upcoming things. Suddenly your thoughts were interrupted by visitors. Accept Alexander, I'm gonna accept Toric. Soldiers are inspired with victory, my king. They need to rest now. What would you like to do next? Let's have a feast. What about the wounded ones? Losses are heavy, my lord. If you like, we can proceed to the chambers of healing. Approach a senator. Okay, so long rows of tents are in front of you. You looked into one of them. Wounded soldiers lie on cots, on tables, and are simply on the ground. Victory does not make them happy. Approach a soldier. I'm going to approach a soldier. I'm going to be a man, boys. Alright, I'm a man of the... I'm a king, I gotta act as one. Almost silently, one of the dying soldiers called to you. Your Majesty, let me touch you. Allow, pull back your hand. I'm gonna allow him. A soldier lightly touched the hem of your clothes with a bloody hand and died a moment later with a smile on his face. But let her go, at least he got what he wanted in the end. You approach the soldier with gangrene on the back of his hand, a field healer tries to amputate his arm, but a soldier resists. Come up with something? Help the healer? Come up with something, boys. You promised to help the soldier's family and gave the appropriate orders. Like a true leader, you spent half a day inspecting the wounded ones and giving orders. Soon the evening came. The wounded soldiers need the rest. Leave the chambers, boys. You went to the other side of the fields where a celebration was being prepared in honor of the victory. Large field was declared from the traces of the battle. Tents were set up. Minstrels and buffoons were called. The victory celebration has begun. Sit aside. To the feast, boys. Let's go to the feast with them. Celebrate with them. You were invited to a round dance at the fire. Around the fire where the banners of the Southerners has been burned. The lights of the holiday attracted peasants and beggars from all over the area. Let the beggars in. Drive away the beggars. Hand over bread. All right, so we either let the beggars in or we hand over the bread. I'm gonna hand out some bread, boys. Whatever. Beggars remained full and dispersed around this district. Their holiday was not spoiled. Well, there we go. Just give them food and they're not gonna ruin the fun for everyone, boys. So there it is. A holiday is in full swing. Paladins and Sir Orlando himself have come to such fun. Driver the paladins. Have fun with the paladins, boys. Have fun with them. The paladin recognized you and broadly smiled. Yeah, of course I'm gonna have fun with them. I mean, they're my friends after all, and I can probably employ them to help me out, like enforce my troops. So you've moved up the career ladder. It's hard to recognize you, by the way. Can you tell me where the magic liquid is? Point to the wine. How are things at the border, my guy? The wall is under reliable protection, Majesty. The noble brother, Drunkberg, remained in the charge of the garrison. Alright, let's point to the wine then. Each paladin took a small barrel and sat comfortably on the grass. Your Majesty, join us. Have fun alone? No. Let's join them, boys. Let's have fun with them. They poured out several goblets of wine. Finally, you take off your tight royal caftan and put on simple clothes. You managed to relax a little. There we go. So you've lost count of which cup of wine you're drinking. Your vision has begun to double. Brother Drunkberg is arguing with one of the knights. Separate? Observe? And who protects the royal now? The brothers of the order look at each other guiltily. One of the paladins decides to change the subject and tells a joke. Having laughed enough, everyone forgets about your question. Alright, I'm gonna observe. Drunkbird was hit hard on the head and flopped to the ground. He soon got up as if nothing had happened and continued to have fun. Alright then. Friends, let's get to the forest. Let's look for dryads. Yeah, let's go. Well, without me this time. Without me this time, you know? You know what? Let's go. Without me. I actually don't know because... Oh, it's kind of rough, boys. Let's go with him. Let's go with him. Let's go all out, boys. I know it's bad. And I got a feeling I know what's gonna happen here. I know what's gonna happen. They're gonna take advantage of us, the southerners. Because now we're having big parties and whatnot. I'm getting drunk. This is not good. You didn't even notice how you ended up in the forest somewhere around here. Around you can hear the drunken cries of your friends calling for dryads. The screams subside. Only the crickets are singing now. Go at random. Call for help. Smell the trail. I'm going to smell the trail, boys. You smell the tread of honey aroma. Crouching to the ground, you follow the trace until you hit Sir Orlando's leg. My brothers, look. Hey, those magical lights. Dryads are calling us. Go to the light. Run away. Oh, I don't know if I should go to the light. That's probably the enemy, though. Fuck, man. This is bad. This is really, really bad. Oh, we're going to the light. The rest of the night was full of fun and unusual experiments. Sometimes you remember it like a magical dream that quickly ended. All right, so that's a extra heart, really. That was actually good for me. All right, then. Torek's loud speech woke you up and gave you terrible headache in the temples. Where am I? Who's here? Okay, well... Torek is shocked by your appearance, but tries to act as if nothing had happened. Well, that's a party monster right here, I guess. So I party hardcore right here, boys. Your Majesty, we need to decide how to lead the war. What is there according to the plans? It is necessary to take advantage and defeat the Southerners and take their capital. I will collect combat-ready banners and wait for you at the fortress. Canyon. Alright, so now we're going into the main capital and stuff and finishing them off once and for all. Let's do that, boys. We have few reserves left after the battle in the valley. I have gathered all the remaining soldiers in one squad under your command. Alright, let's go, boys. We have a few... Okay, so you know, you now have a banner representing one squad of warriors under your command. Good. So, this is my banner right here. There is also bad news. The Southerners outside the wall outnumber us. In addition, there is a gorge right outside the gate. The path to the capital won't be easy. What do you propose to do? Let's use tactics, boys. Torek lost in thought and leaned over in the map. I wouldn't recommend going to the gorge with one squad. It is necessary to find allies in the kingdom and better scout the area. How many squads do we need? At least two more banners. This is enough to equalize the force. Find allies. Alright, well, go find some allies, my guy. I'm afraid I gathered all the people I could. Perhaps your repetition will attract new people? Do you have enough troops? Good to look for allies? I guess I could go myself. Yes, I could go myself, look for allies. So, ways are open everywhere, boys. So, we can go around and look for a bunch of allies. Necessarily, the Academy Tower... First things we're going to do is go there. We're going to go to the Academy Tower, boys. We were a student previously. We were a student of the Academy Tower, so it's important to go there. Our troops are running out of provisions. This can greatly affect the combat capability. Look from the for provisions from the peasants. Settle logistics. Let's just settle logistics. Personally organize the delivery and provisions from nearby villages. The soldiers are no longer starving. There we go. We're just settling logistics, boys. I feel like this the best thing to do is to go to the Academy Tower. Few days in traveling, the Tower of Academy flash on the horizon. Drive past. Look for the allies. Let's go. You were met by the head of the Academy and led to the tower. Good evening, Your Majesty. To what do I owe this visit? Look who it is. The guy I never got to talk to. Get to my brain. I need soldiers. How are things at the Academy? Things are moving. Students are learning. Potions are being brewed, but you didn't come here for that, right? I'm aware of that, what is happening in the kingdom. Alright, I need some soldiers. I understand, Majesty, but the cabinet doesn't train soldiers. Loud bangs were heard around the, outside the window. Looking out, you notice a group of students in a great cloud of smoke. What was that? Callistra took a deep breath. The students are practicing making exploding spores, Your Majesty. This works for me. Are they good for warriors? Of course not. We don't teach military science in the academy. Well, this works for me, I guess. I am aware of your politics, Majesty. Do you really want to take my students? Many of them are not even 14 years old. I'll look for real soldiers? Yes. Any hands needed. Any hands needed is good. Sank into a reverie and walked around the room. The idea, of course, is debatable. Even if you take the students, we still don't have enough exploding spores to provide a combat-ready squad. Well, then gather them. They are not so easy to find. They grow in large numbers only in an abandoned mine, but it is abandoned and deadly. Alright. Well, should I look for them myself? I don't know, Your Majesty. It's up to you. You sat down in a chair and sank into reverie. Soon, Callistra disturbed you to find your own decision. I'll get by without you. There will be... Tell me where the mine is. Why is the mine dangerous in the first place? It is pitted up and down. The old passages are crumbling. The entrance in there is damp and slippery. A couple of my students disappeared there. Tell me where it is. You marked a place on the map and you went there with a group of soldiers. So I'm going there with a group of soldiers. We're going to explore the mine. We're going to get those. I'm determined. I feel like the scholars are going to be the best option. All sorts of potions, all sorts of scientific advancements to the warfare that you can do with us. We don't need strength in our army, boys. We need brains. That's what we need. You sent scout to check the entrance to the mine, but he didn't return. The rest are afraid to go to the mine. Send more soldiers. Show an example of courage. I'm going to show an example. You look into the mine yourself. After walking a few meters, you fall into a hole. You are going downhill at high speed. Group up. Group up right here. Surprisingly, you suffered less injuries from a fall than you thought you would. There we go. You are at the very bottom of the cave. Darkness surrounds you. Shut up. Sit silently. I'm going to sit silently. There we go. You suddenly became sad from such an outcome. Well, you have been sitting for several hours. There's still a silence around. It looks like they don't even think about you saving you. Try to get out, I guess. You got up and felt the space around you. There are no passages here, and the ceiling of the cave is very low. Grope the floor, I guess. You grope the armor. This is the body of one of your soldiers. It feels like a day has gone by. You are terribly hungry and thirsty. Also, you're getting claustrophobic, whatever that means. Dig into the ground. Wait. Dig into the ground. Dropping your hands, you found a beetle larva and without hesitation threw it into your mouth. Ugh, that's disgusting, boys. You have been sitting in the hole for several days now and have been studied every stone here. Hunger has exhausted you so much that it seems as if death is only the threshold. Taste a soldier? I don't have a choice, boys. I'm a cannibal now. There it is. I hate a soldier. You lost the track of time and started going crazy. You start to hallucinate and hear voices of some people. Scream. You see your vision of some soldiers descending on rope ladders. Lifted you up. Well, there we go, boys. I'm sorry it took so long. We checked all the passages in these mines to find you. There are also some good news. We have collected several boxes of mushrooms. Execute the soldier? Try to come to your senses. I'm gonna come to my senses, of course. You've been coming to your senses for several days while the heroes nursed you. When you got the better, you returned to the academy. Well, we got the mushrooms, boys. At least we did it. That was not easy. Almost died from that, but in the end, we did what we had to do. I see it was not easy for you, but you chose this path yourself. I gave the order to prepare stocks of explosive spores. You will soon receive a new squad. There we go. Our banner increase, boys. Banners of the academy students. Your army has grown. The best students of the academy now serve you. There it is. Now, so they are teenagers, but nevertheless, boys, they might be teenagers, but they still will help us tremendously. I mean, they've got they literally have exploding stuff. Now I could go and try Christian's village, but I'm not gonna do that. The old mines, dense forest. Why would I go in there? The paladins. Now obviously the paladins are really strong. They helped me out with the troll boys, the troll problem. So obviously we're gonna require their help. They're gonna be good help. You arrive at the Paladin's Fortress. You are met by a sentry and you notice that the fortress is empty. Where's everyone? The sentry is guiltily scratching his head. Well, where do they go? Emergency. Sir Orlando, most of the Paladins aren't here right now. Where do they go? They went into the passes of the gorge to reconnoiter the situation. When will they return, I guess? You unusually returns the next day, but they've been gone for 3 days. They are in danger, I guess. Oh, they are in danger, I think. I doubt it, Your Majesty. Maybe a barrel of wine was stolen from them and they went looking for it. Anyway, it's unclear when they will return. The paladin is waiting for your questions. We can do without them. You're way too responsible. You will find them. We will find them. We'll find them. I wish you good luck, sir. Come back soon. All right. So, well, we're going to go ahead and go into the gorge and find them. We're going to find them, boys. Whatever. Take a few experienced soldiers with you and prepare for a sortie in the gorge. Hit the road. Conduct the reconnaissance first. We got to do reconnaissance, boys. So, the soldier discovered an ambush of robbers and dealt with it. No one was hurt. Their road is now safe. There it is. Let's hit the road, boys. That's a good news right there. The road leads uphill and soon you observe a view of the gorge. There is a column of smoke ahead. Rush there. Keep wandering around. Rush there, boys. You reach the village. Several houses burned down and smoldering wood indicated that the arsonists have been here recently. Let's look around. Leaflets are scattered everywhere and a little further on the road is something else lying around. Your guardsmen inspect the traces. Read the leaflet, wanted dead or alive, what is lying over there? Let me examine the traces first. There we go. You find paladin's tracks faster than your guards. The soldiers are impressed. I know about that, boys. Advance along the only possible path through the overhanging cliffs until you reach a fork. Examine the traces. There's a rocky soldier. It's useless to think of traces here. Okay, well. Do we go right or left, boys? Let's go left. Alright, so you have stumbled upon a pilgrim's tent from the south. Seeing you, a black man immediately hides inside. Rob him. Talk with him. Realizing that you have no evil intentions, a man allowed you to enter his tent. He says, "Note, paladin have passed through here." Alright, well, we gotta go to the right then, boys. The soldiers have begun to be thirsty. You notice a small muddy pool of water ahead. Don't drink from there. Drink the water. Go ahead, drink. If you only knew how many scary little creatures this water added in, and how bad it would have become for you later, but that would be later. Well, it is what it is, boys. They had to drink. A barely audible roar was heard about the slope. Listen closely. Listen closer. Wait. I'm gonna listen closer, boys. You stop and try to determine the direction of the sound. Sounds like it's coming from the slope ahead of the rope. Run or wait? Let's wait, boys. Let's wait. You just waited until the rockfall came down into the road and moved on. An open area stretches out in front of you and another column of smoke appears on the horizon. Oh, you rock the muddy water you recently drank. So here is the place it's rushing out. Oh, great. Because of the water, I lost an art. That's okay, though. Opium stretches in front of you. Another column of smoke appears. Let's hurry there. Using one of the mountain roads and lock, you quickly get to the right place. You are observing an interesting picture. Paladins roll a large oak barrel out of a burning building, and Orlando commands it all. What is it? Orlando sees you and throws up his hands in greeting. Your Majesty, glad to see you. How did you end up so far from our lands? Explain the situation right now, my guy. You reprimand the paladin with highly emotional expressions. Please forgive us. Our supplies ran out and we had to make a sortie to fulfill them. By the way, this is our bestie, Betsy. Let me treat you. It's no time. I have a war, my guy. Actually, sir, you are probably not just looking for us. Fulfill your oath. There we go. They need to fulfill their oath to me, boys. After all, they do have an oath to me, so they need to get with me. So, a sober Orlando is presently a very accommodating and courteous person. He quickly takes you out to the gorge of the gorge and selects his best fighters. Your army has grown. Well, there we go, boys. We can still gather more troops, though. We can still gather more troops, which I will gladly do. We got 3 banners, which is more than enough to go up against the enemy. But we can still gather more. So we will gather more. We're going to go to Christian's village now. We've got the bombs. We've got the paladins. We're good, boys, but we need more. You quartered the guards in the village tavern and move towards Christian's house. There is no single soul near the entrance. Knock on the door. Quietly enter. Knock on the door. Christian's guards open the door. Oh, the king has come. Come up here. Come up here, your majesty, since you've already come. All right, where to go? You are escorted to Christian's office. In addition to the owner himself, there's a peasant dressed in a shabby leather armor in the room. I'm glad you rang allies, my guy. You demand Christian to allocate to people who are capable of holding weapons. Your majesty, I've already heard about the war and understand your request, but do you know how these syncretists affected my lands? Well, no. Then I'll tell you. Many went to the war and never returned, and the robbers have become more daring. They're raiding our village recently, killed cattle and took away women. So will you give people? Well, do you need help against them? I have to ask. Gondo will show you where the bandit camp is, and you can get them to leave the robberies and return the woman to us. Then my people will follow you. I agree. Let's do that. I'll start gathering people, and in case of success, they will march under your banner. Otherwise, they will remain to defend their own. All right, good. We'll do that. We'll sparse out these robbers, boys. Let's examine the camp. Fuck camp is your majesty. I'm going back to the village. All right, let's examine the camp. Many bandits scattered around the camp, so it was difficult to count them. Lots of loot going on. 2 strategies come to mind. Openly fight and try to negotiate, or leading the soldiers to an ambush. Guards are in ambush. Give them a fight. We're ambushing them, boys. Obviously, we're gonna ambush them. So the soldiers hide by dense bushes, but in which case they are ready to rush to help you. There we go. So we're gonna ambush them. Look who's rolling wheels towards us. Hey guys, there's a rich gentleman. Well, let's think about our mournful deeds. These guys do not know who they're dealing with. Call the boss. Here I am in front of you in all my glory. Look who's rolling. Okay, so challenge to a duel. Persuade them. We can challenge them to a duel, but let's try and persuade them. You decide to convince the bandits to stop looting. Maybe they will even agree to join your army. Exactly. That's amusing. Well, first off, we'll first take the gold and clothes, and then I'll think about your request. Intimidate with Christian. Intimidate with guards. I am the king. Well, intimidate with the guards. I'm going to intimidate them with the guards. Yeah, I'm going to do that. Rustle and clinches of armor can be heard from the butchers. It sounds plausible. You convince me. I will not touch you, but I will not fulfill your request just like that either. Let's play a fair game of wishes. What game is it? Is this? You see the balls? Whoever drinks first the bottom and does not wins is the winner. All right. Sure. Let's do it. It's used for the guards to sit in ambush and they go out to the bandits on the order. All right. So you are invited to the table and 2 large bowls were brought. They pour a drink from the ringleader from one barrel and to you from another. The judge is waiting for readiness. Let me check the drink first. You demand that one of the bandits taste your drink. Bandit takes the ball and sinks at his leader. After a moment, he sits and immediately falls to the ground. You almost got caught. It was poison. I knew it. You draw your swords and the guards line up in battle. I knew they were going to do that. About 100 of bandits are yelling, provoking you. But no one wants to start the fight first. The leader of the bandits comes forward and offers you a duel. No duel fight. No duel, fight, or agree to duel, or And what do I need it for? Well, one of you, open your eyes and there are whole hundred of us here. My boys will tear you apart and I suggest you resolve this dispute with little blood. I mean, I thought you would be kind enough to actually do an actual game and stuff like that. But I guess not, boys. They really wanted to poison me, these assholes. All right, guardsmen and bandits from a city and you. Form a circle and you and the leader go into the center. Someone makes bets and the enemies draw a short sword and start jumping around you. All right, time to do a duel, boys. And I won a duel against my cousin, so I'm gonna be fine. I'll teach you a lesson you will never forget. Got you. Are you scared? Come on, come on. Show me what you can do. Lunge. Hit him with the back. Hit him with the back of the hand. There we go, boys. The bandit barely dodges a blow. His people start to whistle and stomp their feet. The enemy throws a hidden in the sleeve dagger at you. Dodge. Dodge and attack. Dodge and attack, boys. Oh shit, I lost an art. That's not good. The bandit has a second dagger in his hands from which he can no longer dodge. Damn. The enemy launches at you, awkwardly brandishing two swords. Defend yourself. Attack. Defend. What? Why? How am I losing this shit? The leader runs up to his men and takes the heavy hammer from him. Now he swings in your direction. Block the hammer. Step aside. You jump into the side and plump down in the dirt. The armor didn't hit you, but everyone around you is laughing. Damn, man. The exhausted bandit looks around in the aura and, not having to come up with anything better, takes to his heels. Really? Those who bet on the leader sighed in disappointment and pour coins to the frail kid. He just fled? He said, fuck it, I'm not doing this anymore. Really? He was winning, too. Bandits scattered in all directions. They seem to have lost interest in their activities. The guards free the prisoners. Well, arrest the others, I guess. Yeah, arrest the others. Without a leader, most of the bandits surrounded themselves. Satisfied with your work, you return to the village. There we go. This is wonderful. Our village will always be grateful to you. By the way, there are a lot of people who want to perform you under banner. Except the militia, boys. Now we got a militia. We got four banners. There it is. Christian takes you to the village. And we got the militia. There it is. So now we've got four banners, boys. Not only three, but four. We are doing great. We really are doing great right now. We got two more places we can gather people from. We can gather them from the old mines. At the dense forests. I'm not sure if I should do that. Let me go to the old mines. We'll see if the old mines is going to be good enough. What's in there? Your squad needed a rest and you stopped in the vicinity of the old mines. A morning meal was interrupted by the head of the guard. Let's listen to the report. The soldiers have surrounded the camps of bandits, but there are a whole hundred of them. Luckily, we have the advantage and they have nowhere to run. Okay, spare no one. Could they fight for us? Excuse me, but this is not reasonable. What kind of warriors can they be? Spare no one. Lead the parliamentary. Yeah, lead them. Bandit sent a negotiator. His face looked familiar to you. Well, well. You again, brother. So you think you're the... So you're the king already. You always get all the bets best. How did you survive? Yeah, how did he survive this? I thought he died. And you keep doing robbery. Let your people fight for me. Let your people fight for me. Ari narrowed his eyes as if he were talking nonsense. But then he gained an answer. Does anyone start a conversation like that? What about a drink? How about no? Alric waved his hand at you. You are such a bore. What's next? Will you put me in jail? Put Alric in jail? Alright, fine. I'll have a drink. What? Deviant, confusion reigns in the army camp. Does the king drink with the criminal? No one has seen such nonsense. Well, whatever, man. A large table was set up in the tent. A variety of drinks were brought by order. Soon it got dark and the guards left you alone with Alric. Talk about your father. Talk straight to the point. No, talk about the father. Let's talk around. I guess that's what he wants. He wants us to talk around the whole thing. Alric frowned and drank a bottle of wine in one gulp. What is there to say about that bastard? Threw my mother away when she was pregnant. That was the king. Are you sure that was the case, my guy? Well, Helvino, my mother died when I was small, but she told me a lot about this story. There are two options. Either it's true or she's crazy. Is that why you wanted to kill me? No, they just paid me well for you. They just paid well for you. And when they said to you that you were a prince, I became doubly interested. Doubly interested, judging by the fate, we look like the same person. A sad fate indeed. Well, you have a good wine, brother. Now look at the donkey urine from a tavern. Would you kill me now? Well, no, they don't offer me money for you anymore. All right, so who tried to kill me exactly? I have no idea. I only communicate with a messenger who ran into the cave all the time. And then remember, he killed my entire team. Let's go down to business already. Ulrich growled loudly and patted his belly. Okay, now we can get down to business. You have a crazy plan. How are we going to win over the assassins, robbers, and the other trash? You'll go and persuade them. You're better than me at this. Come on now. Well, let's see. What's next? What would I tell them? What can they fight for? For honor? For duty? For duty? I guess for honor. Yeah, for honor. Why not? Aldred laughed so hard that he nearly fell to his heart, but then he became serious and took off a coin. Do you see it? It's money. It's material. And your honor is an empty phrase. No better than my fart. Well, that's true. That is true. Then for money. If they don't join, then they'll die in the morning. Well, I guess they can be paid, right? They can be paid. I got money. You promised the bandits that they would be able to plunder and loot on the lands of the southerners. Exactly. And by the way, what's my interest? I won't execute you. Great, I recognize my own blood. I'm going to talk to these scumbags right away. Ulrich went to negotiate with the bandits. Several hours has passed. We're going to wait. We're going to wait. An hour of tedious waiting passes, suspiciously quietest around. Let's send a squad, I guess. Not far from the bandit camp, you found Ulrich's chopped up body. It turns out that your proposal was not accepted. Well, they did not accept my proposal, and they killed Ulrich. It is what it is, I guess. The bandits began to break through the encirclement with a fight. The battle turned out to be hard. Many of your soldiers were killed, and no one survived from the gang of bandits. Continue traveling, boys. I failed to get a new ally. That's unfortunate. So we couldn't get the bandits on our side. That's really unfortunate. So next up is going to be the dense forest. We're going to do that in the next video, boys. We're going to try and gather some enemies from the dense forest. Remember to leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. I'll see you guys for the next one. Keep it easy.